Today, I'm going to show you how to create this glowing wavy text effect inside After Effects, and then we'll bring it over to Premiere for animated subtitles. Let's check it out. All right, so over here in After Effects, take your text tool and type some text. I'm using this nice bubbly font called Mogra. Open up the text layer and come down to Text, Animate, and select Position. When we increase that position, that moves all the characters of our text layer. And when we select the text animator position, you can see these little red X's at the baseline of each letter. We can delete the range selector, and instead we'll add an expression selector. The expression selector lets us write expressions that affect every character of the text layer. We're going to write a custom expression in here. Set position to 20, and then delete all of this, but keep text index. At the front, write math.sin, parentheses, and then put the text index inside the parentheses. Outside the parentheses, write times 100. Click out, and now as we increase the position, you'll see that those X's for all of our characters have been moved, and we have this sine wave shape going across every letter. We can change the text, and that sine wave continues, and we can control the height of the sine wave from this position animator. In this video, I'm showing you a practical example of how to use math.sin with text animators. But if you want a deep dive lesson all about the sine function, go check out this video by Evan Abrams. He does a great breakdown. Okay, so to make this sine wave move across time, we can come into the expression and write plus time. Click out, and now our sine wave is moving across time. To speed it up, you can just multiply time by 2, and now the sine wave moves twice as fast. To perfectly cycle the sine wave once per second, you can also multiply by math.py. I think that's a bit too fast for reading text, so I'll delete math.py and leave it as time times 2. And reset position to 20. I want this text to fade on, so let's open up the text and go to Animate Opacity. This creates Animator 2. Toggle open the range selector and set a keyframe at 0 seconds. Move forward 10 frames and bring the start to 100%. Change opacity to 0, and now our letters fade on one at a time. For a smoother fade, we can open up Advanced and change the shape to ramp up. We can offset the fade to the left and to the right. Delete the start keyframes and set offset to minus 100 at the start, and then 100 at the end. This looks a lot smoother. I'll set Ease Low to 100% and Ease High to 80%. You can play with the easing here, but I think this is a nice speed. Next, select Animator 2, Add Property, Blur, and set the blur to 2 or 3. Now when the letters come in, they're slightly out of focus and then fade on, and I think that little detail just adds a lot. The text animation is done, let's add some details. We could just add an effect like Deep Glow, turn the radius down, and be done. But I want to show you how to do this without using any extra plugins, and give it some extra oomph. Go to Layer, Precompose, and I'll call this Original Text. Duplicate the precomp and name it Red. Come to Effects and search for Fill, and drop the fill onto that precomp. Now we have two layers. We have a red fill on top, and the bottom is our original. Move red below the original text, and then hold shift and drag the parent pick whip to parent it to the original text layer. Select red and press down on the arrow keys to move the position down. Duplicate it again, and let's change the color of the fill to a nice deep purple. Move that below red and a few pixels down, and then duplicate it once more. This one will be blue, and move that down as well. And if we play this back, they all move together. Come to Layer, New Adjustment Layer, and drag the adjustment layer below the original text. I'll call this one Blur, and then search for a directional blur. Turn up the blur length, and that creates a vertical blur for all the colors, making it look like one smooth gradient. But when I turn on transparency, this is too blurred out. Add a levels effect and change the channel to alpha. Drag this back end down, and that gets rid of the feathering on the edges. If we go too far, it gets really chunky and pixelated, so keep it around 25 to clamp that alpha channel and have a smooth edge. If you get this fringing, you can bring up the other end also. Now let's search for a glow and apply it, and turn up the radius. If we bring the intensity down, that creates a black halo around our letters, and I don't want that black halo. So leave intensity at 1 and double click the glow. In the timeline below the glow effect, come down to compositing options. And now we can turn down the effect opacity which lowers the strength of just that glow. I'll bring that down to 50%. Okay, let's add a soft glow to the white text. Instead of the glow effect, I'll use a fast box blur. Turn blur up to 2, and to bring back the sharpness of the original text, apply CC composite, and then uncheck RGB only, and that brings back the core of our text. And now we can dial in that edge blur with the fast box blur. We can turn iterations to 2, maybe make the radius 3, and I think this looks like a nice soft glow, just something light on top. And there we go, we have a nice glowing wavy text effect. So now we have our base animation in After Effects, but how do we get it into Premiere? We can export a MOGRT. Come up to Window, Essential Graphics. Anything we drag into this panel, we'll be able to edit in Premiere. Go back to the original text comp and open up the wavy text layer. Drag your source text property into the panel. And now we can edit the text from this panel. Click Edit Properties and turn all of these on so we can edit the font size, and text properties all in Premiere. Let's also drag in that position text animator and rename it Wave Height. That way we can control the height of our waves from the MOGRT. Come to the Essential Graphics panel and name it Wavy Text, and then come down to Export Motion Graphics Template. Hit Save, export to the local templates folder, hit OK on all these, and then hop over to Premiere. We'll open the Captions and Graphics workspace, because that has the Essential Graphics panel, and then come to the Browse tab. The MOGRT that we exported should be at the top, but if you don't see it, just search Wavy Text, and then you can drag that onto your timeline. Hit play, and there's our wavy text. Select it, and we can edit the text inside the Essential Graphics panel. You have full access to the font properties and the wave height. Now I'll bring in some footage and come to the text panel. In Transcript, hit Transcribe. We can edit the transcript, and then hit the Create Captions button. Let's bring length way down, and then the duration in seconds down to 1.2, and that creates a caption track. And now we can just copy our text from our captions and paste it inside our MOGRT. We can double-click the MOGRT and reposition or resize it in the program monitor. In the timeline, hold Alt on PC or Option on Mac, and then click and drag the MOGRT to the next caption. We'll come forward and then copy that text and paste it into the MOGRT, and then duplicate it one more time for the last caption. I'll hit the eyeball to turn the captions off, and then I'll just trim this back end with the razor tool. Play it back, and there we go. Now we have these awesome glowing subtitles in Premiere. So this workflow is pretty straightforward, and I wanted to show you every step along the way of how to do it yourself. But if you're making a lot of animated subtitles inside Premiere, I built a tool to make this whole process way easier. It lets you build any MOGRT inside After Effects, like we just did, and then generate a subtitle sequence inside Premiere. It's called Captioneer. Let me show you how it works. Here I have a longer sequence and it's already transcribed, but I'm going to use Captioneer to insert all the MOGRTs automatically. Simply come to these three dots and hit Export to SRT file. I'll export that to my desktop, and then come to Window, Extensions, Captioneer. I'll open the Finder, go to my desktop, and drag the SRT file we created onto the panel. Select the wavy text MOGRT, come to Create, and hit Add MOGRTs. And they all land instantly on the timeline with the correct text and timing from our captions. I'll turn off that caption track and then reposition one of the MOGRTs. Then hit Control C to copy it and select all the other MOGRTs and right click and go to Paste Attributes and hit OK. And that pastes our position and size changes to all of the MOGRTs. But we can even edit the internal MOGRT settings like font and wave height and copy and paste that change. Just hit copy inside Captioneer, then select all the MOGRTs and hit the paste button. And the essential graphic settings inside the MOGRTs update for all of them. So that's how to create this wavy text inside After Effects and bring it to Premiere for subtitles. If you want to speed up your workflow, go check out Captioneer at captioneer.tv. Aside from that, catch you in the next one.